occurs, what does happen? What you just get? What you just get?
Right? So, like,
cause hallucinations and stuff? Hallucinations and stuff, yeah. So, people see demons. They say they see that demon. If it's a larger bless, sukunya, whatever, they say they see. Right? Some people say they see. Right? All that because of sleep paralysis. Some people say they feel that something heavy on their chest. They say that demon. Right? Because of sleep paralysis. Right? All others that come from sleep paralysis. You feel something heavy on the chest and you see things. Right? Again, the reason why I just see things is because, right? Speak on my time over here. Right. Yeah, so again, I'm going to talk about Afghanistan community. I just want to finish off this, how do you say, this myth, right, about voodoo and obia that it exists. It does not exist. Voodoo and obia does not exist. It is not real, right? If you seeing some man flying in the sky, or you see somebody with a head turning around back to front, right? There's either two things. It's either you're under sleep paralysis, or what? What's the next thing? It's either you have sleep paralysis, right? Or what's the next thing?
Yes, yeah, so I can't see.
Uh-huh.
Or you have a demon on you.
You have a demon on you, yes, that is correct. One more thing.
Okay,
one more thing. You have a demon in you.
Okay.
Is your sleep paralysis? Maybe you're seeing somebody head turn around back to front, somebody flying in the sky.
Okay.
Right? So is you have a demon in you, sleep paralysis, or?
Okay,
yeah.
You need to come off drugs.
You need to come off drugs, right? Is the next thing? Mm-hmm. Come, I'll show you about the next thing is you're watching too much TV. Right? Just watching too much TV. Right? You see somebody head turning around and you end up believing that. You understand? Right. So everybody here, right? Now, as Maka said, a demon in you, right? A demon does come in many forms and fashion, right? You might name of a demon. When I say a name, like a holy name, now, a holy name. So we just see demons every day. Got different names here. Right? So give my name of a demon. Remember, we just see demons every day. You go into school, you see that demon. You go to church, you see that demon. Everywhere you go in, see that demon.
Oh, okay.
Right? So, yeah.
Cesar Borgia.
Yeah.
a drug addict?
Yeah, a drug addict, yeah. But I want like a specific name. Okay, like what a drug addict does go through? Alright, what's somebody? Alright, let me get an example, right? Paranoia is a demon.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Wagi.
Schizophrenic
is a demon. Wagi.
Yeah. Like
somebody
who just who taught the murderer, but a white man who's a murderer by nature.
Yeah, he put a demon in me. Where
am
I?
Bipolar
disorder. This is paranoia, bipolar disorder. The next one.
Prostitution.
Yeah, what do you want, yeah?
Homosexuality.
Let me get our next one. Anxiety disorder. Is that demon? Next one.
Depression.
Or we like to call the PTS.
PTSD? Yeah.
Where's PTSD?
Post-traumatic stress disorder.
Right? Post-traumatic. Post-traumatic stress disorder. Try our next one, let's call it. Post-traumatic sleeve syndrome. Right? So all them things we just call demon, right? All them things is demon. Right? Demon in possession is really, you see it every day, right? You see it every day. Smoking weed, drugs, as we say. Homosexuality, you see it every day. Demon in possession is not TV. Right? It's not something on Facebook. Right? Demon in possession is the policeman who in the hood. He just want to pull out his battle or his weapon, his gun, just to beat up some black boy, just to feel better on a daily basis. That is a demonic possession. You understand? Why again? I don't know anything again? Fear is a demon, yes, because Israel wasn't supposed to have fear on them, yes. Some people, mothers had a demon in them in the hood, right? How we know that? Some people's father had a demon in the hood. How do you know that?
Like I said, maybe they were alcoholics. They were probably depressed.
They were alcoholics, they were depressed. Some people's experience, you know, the mother's spend time caring with the man that they're having sex with rather than them. You understand? Or like a demonic possession. Right? The man in the household will just want to sell everything, sell the TV, the fridge, the stove, sell everything in the house just to get drugs. And all the demonic possession. That's how you know your father and your mother have demonic possession in there. Right? So you just see demonic possession every day. It's not something jump inside and or something flying in the sky, right? You see it every day, right? Again, schizophrenic again. Go ahead.
It's swept under the rug in the black community, so child abuse, sir.
Child abuse, yeah, all that. I'm demonic possession, all that. Go ahead, Shah.
I'm going to call it demon, right? Like the third, like the three. terminate abusers, revelers, extortioners, drunkards.
Yes. All, yeah, all those are considered people who have demons in them, yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. No, for the people who does, you know, say there are people who does jump up and twist off and the neck might literally turn all the way, who knows? Right? The neck might literally turn all the way. I know all the way, but close to all the way, right? Right? They have a demon in them, but what is that demon called? So you might really see somebody with a neck turning around. Or somebody twisting up and rolling on the ground. They might try to fly and then get you. That might do other small thing. Understand? So they have a demon in them, but what is that demon called?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't need to burn.
So like yes, I know some persons they take drugs or some sort of hallucinogen. You will act that way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, all I'm thinking is demon possession. The drugs are at the stake, yes. Apart from cigarettes and weed, has some called heroin, you know. Sometimes this has some. Apart, like heroin is another type of drug that makes you freeze. People are literally freezing up like statues, freezing. You understand? All that is demonic possession. The heroin. A mother wants a prostitute, she eat Monty old child. And all that is demonic possession, right?
Okay.
So again, my can go just tag people on YouTube now. People who know anything, you know. Tag them. Political sentiment on Facebook. Tag them on Facebook, you know. Right? So again, this is why the people who taking drugs and who prostituting the 8 months old child and all them things. This is why it had the Hebrew Academy for. Right? To already, how to say, be told that demon inside of us. You understand? Because in here, as Christ said, be perfect as his Father in heaven is perfect. You understand? So this is why I had the Hebrew Academy for, so every day I come, you know, you do the training, they keep training me, doing me. The Hebrew Academy just keep getting harder and harder and harder. It was designed to know if you're weak, if you had a demon in you and that demon, how you so weak, and you go just say, nah, this is not for me, and you go leave. You understand? We won't kick you out of the Hebrew Academy. You go and say, nah, this is not for me. Right? All I say is that demon inside of you. So they might have the Hebrew Academy for to really push out that demon out there. So you're gonna be perfect. You understand? Okay. Instead of the ISGPK, our standards is higher than everybody else's standards.
Okay.
This is why we could say we are perfect. Because of our standards that we have. You understand? When they go to church, they do, they are not need to change it. They need to be in the church. Alright, somebody give me Genesis 49:5.
Right? Genesis 49:5.
Yeah,
can. Yeah. Genesis 49:5. Simeon and Levi our brethren.
Similar to our brethren, right?
Instruments of cruelty are in their habitations.
Right. But what is the instrument of cruelty?
Locusts.
Yeah.
Witchcraft, sir.
Right, witchcraft. Right, all them things. You know, cutlass, machete. No, that's probably the cutlass that the machete. That's the only correct name for it?
Yeah, I understand.
Understand? Voodoo. Obia. Instrument of cruelty is in their hand, right? That would say, right?
Done.
Mm-hmm. And of course, you know that Levi and Simeon. When they say they are what? Levi and Simeon are what?
They cannot answer. Verse 5. Simeon and Levi are brethren.
Right.
Instruments of cruelty are in their habitations.
Mm-hmm. That is it?
That's verse 5, sir.
We all know the issue about Simeon, Levi and Simeon, right? We all know today is Levi is what? Today? Haiti. Simeon is what?
Dominican Republic,
right? What's the name for Levi in Hebrew?
Yes,
like Lawyer. And Simeon is what? Yeah.
Shemai one.
Right? So, and Shemai one, you know? They have to get on the same island, just different than Mars. You know, two of them, basically, they had a little differences with each other. You know, and the Levites being the ones who know more about the medicines, herbs. Right, and those kind of stuff, the medicine, the herbs, they know how to mix this herb with that herb to make it get paralyzed, and how to make that herb with this herb to make it get poisoned or some kind of skin disorder. So, you know, so the vice and them just decide one day, well, all right, then we hop on one foot, cut off a chicken egg, mix up some herbs, throw it in their face, and then go feel it something. Voodoo, we call it voodoo, and they go believe it. You can believe the chicken foot will have power. But no, it's just different herbs they're mixing up.
And then,
yeah.
Where did influence come from in terms of that learning how to use herbs for wickedness? Come from the other nations and them, or where did it come from?
Yes, really, it's only the other nations that could come from. Right? It's only the other nations that could come from. Right? That's when he got enough in, the Lord said, see from this tree. We'll learn nothing from this tree. And so we still went and the other nations, well, they went to the woman, right, and influenced she. She went and influenced her husband.
Okay.
And so, yes, it's something that was learned. And all them things is something that was learned.
Okay.
Right, from Israel. Right? And from the, I believe it's Romans 9 or Romans 4, talk about death reigned from Adam to Moses, right? Decided to sin after, right? Still following the other nations right now, Israel, still following the other nations. You understand? Someone give me a, yeah, go ahead, sure.
Right, I know Levi, like, you know, like, as a mountain to reality, like, I know Levi, still Levi, so. What's Simeon? Where do you feel like Simeon? Like, where they are, what them, how that?
Simeon? I'm too sure what Simeon have. Could be basically the same thing, right? As the scripture how it says, it was two of them as brethren, right? And the same.
Like,
yeah, go ahead.
If I'm mistaken, the Dominicans known for the same type of mixture of herbs and voodoo as well.
And then when there's supposed to be so many baddest people with switchblade, with a knife, a blast, the same thing as E.T. But I think the Dominicans bad, and I think at least our British and from the Caribbean standpoint, I'm not too sure if it's true, but just CSA, you know? People just like to give a bad stigma, to give a bad stigma to all the other tribes as well, Benjamin smokers, Julian workless, delinquent, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, again, I'm too sure what is Simeon. Let me think about all the Levites and them. The same as that, right?
Okay.
Exodus 22. Right. Who have Exodus 22 and 20? Exodus 22 and 20.
22 and?
Exodus 22 and 20. I don't want to run all the time. Let's talk about Sabga.
Hello,
I don't want to run all the time.
Exodus chapter 22 and verse 20. He that sacrificeth unto any god, save unto the Lord only, he shall be utterly destroyed.
Mm-hmm. Keep reading.
Verse 21. Thou shalt neither vex a stranger nor oppress him, for ye were strangers in the land of Egypt.
Word.
Verse 22. Ye shall not afflict any widow or fatherless child.
Right.
Verse 23. If thou afflict them in any wise, they shall cry at all unto me. I will surely hear their cry, and my wrath shall wax hot, and I will kill you with the sword, and your wives shall be widows, and your children fatherless.
Right. And so basically, the scripture is saying, why you do food and over, you go die.
Okay.
Right? From 20 to 24, right?
Okay.
And either you shall not vex a stranger, right? No oppressing, for you are strangers in the land of Egypt, talking about Israel, right? We are strangers, right? Right, a lot of them. Leviticus 19 and 26.
It's like I said, repeat again.
Leviticus 19 and 26. I'm going to talk about Sabga. I'm going to write that.
All of them of it?
I don't care.
Leviticus chapter 19 and verse 26. He shall not eat anything with the blood, neither shall he use enchantment nor observe times.
Right? You shall not eat anything with the blood, right? Some people just use food and over there, just drink chicken blood, they just drink human's blood, all kind of things. Right? That is a law in the Bible. Do not do that.
Okay.
Right? Neither shall use any enchantment. Christianity was made by man, just like food was made by man, right?
Okay.
So if you look up our enchantment. You see, it's a clock. I got to do the sub cutting. I want to follow it.
I don't cancel. Enchantment. A feeling of great pleasure delight. enchantment of the mountains. Synonyms: magic, witchcraft, sorcery, wizardry, necromancy, conjuncture.
Right. And all that is Christianity, right? Necromancy, what again is it?
Magic, witchcraft,
all that is in the Christian church, right? All that is Christianity, all that was made by man, voodoo. All them things was made by man, right?
Exactly, so.
Yeah.
It's also a second term, meaning which the state of being under is spell.
Right. Church, again, right? Man, for 400 years you were slave, and the church say, nah, nice small thing. And so study, what did they say? Study 9/11 or study Hitler with the Holocaust. But forget what slave. We fall on that spell and say, yes, you're right. The Holocaust was something really bad. But 400 years of slavery, blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians was oppressed. And we still oppressed today. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The church enchanted we. You know, they dim the lights, they had the nice music. You know, we dance, we wine in the church. So yeah, we fall for it. We fall for that. Yeah.
Okay. So the way to phrase it is like such a small gift destroy your people heart.
Mm-hmm.
Destroy your mind.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Destroy your mind, destroy your heart. Right? But again, thank you for the Most High. Since 1969, Yarrow's prophets already come out and, you know, teach the nation of Israel, right? Christianity's ally, and it's right in the Bible. Christ called the religious leaders, the Christians, hypocrites. He called them hypocrites in the Bible. John the Baptist say, who will tell Allah to come and get baptized? Allah can't run from the wrath that is to come from Allah. When the Christian leaders come to get baptized. You understand? And then we see that the church, they don't mention those things in church, they just leave it out. Right? So, all right, I don't want to run away times. Let me gain time. Let me pull up on that voodoo and enchantment, something for now. Yeah, I'm the Sabga.
Right?
I don't want to run away time. Right? I'm not going to read from this. See what's the name of the book, right? The name of the book.
From the humble beginnings, the phenomenal inspirational life story of Dr. Anthony Norman Sabga.
Right, so from the humble beginnings of the what?
Of the phenomenal inspirational life story of Dr. Anthony Norman Sabga.
Right, so this is a book we're reading from the humble beginnings.
By
right?
Philip Guy Rochford.
Right, by Philip Guy Rochford. Philip Guy Rochford wrote this book, right? From humble beginnings. He's talking about who Anthony Norman Sabga. Right, but before we read it, and you have the videos in? You have the videos? Could be first one up. Not when he apologized. The next one. Not that one, the next one before that. Then after you get that. Next one. got CNN. CNN, you're good. Which one was it? David? Volume in there. On the volume. And so some guy is saying here that he's boasting and saying there's the least, but there's the most powerful in Trinidad, right? There's 1%, there's the least of them in Trinidad, but there's the most powerful. He's boasting and saying, I'm talking about he has 120 restaurants, right? This had caused an uproar in Trinidad with citizens, but again, because, you know, he's really the most powerful in Trinidad, you know, they got quiet after a while. People stopped talking about it, right? So there's him here boasting. Sapga.
Right? Yeah, he's for this ethnic group in Trinidad.
But the most powerful.
So
they say they call them the Starbucks in the Caribbean. You have 150 restaurants or 20 restaurants, I was in there. And of course, he's on CNN, right?
Okay.
He's on CNN, so he come boasting about it. He can't learn uproar, but citizens got quiet after a while because, yeah, they don't know he's the most powerful. The most of things he won. Right? But, for the next one.
Okay.
He apologized.
Chairman of the group.
So after he outcry, he just wrote an apology.
Global Brand Group of Companies Mario Sabda Booth has apologized for statements made on the recently broadcast CNN show Parts Unknown that featured Trinidad and Tobago. The comments by the Rituals Pizza Boys Church's Chicken owner have stirred anger and disapproval by nationals. In a media release posted online, Mr. Sabda Wood said he used careless words and misrepresented himself and his values. Mr. Sabda Wood said he has never taken for granted the blessing to be a born and bred Trinbagonian and has always been humbled by the opportunities and support he received in over 30 years of business. He said he always treats with appreciation, love and respect the members of his staff, many of whom are like his family. Mr. Sandra Wood ended by saying the moment was regrettable and excitement led him to misrepresent himself as boastful instead of proud. He said although he cannot retract his words, he hopes that his remorse and sincerest apologies are recognized.
All right, so tonight I want to talk a little bit about Sabga. So he boasts, he say he apologize after for boasting. Understand? So let me get into the little history about Sabga, because some people that say he come here poor, he had no money, he was broken, and he sell clothes, and from selling clothes, he make money, then he open up a business, then he just get bigger and bigger and expand. Right? So let me see the history about Sabga. You see if it's really true with Sabga and the Syrian community. Right, so where Michael tell him the book again?
from the humble beginnings.
So there's a book called From the Humble Beginnings. Go ahead.
The phenomenal inspirational life story of Dr. Anthony Norman Savage.
Life story of Dr. Anthony Norman Savage. By who?
By Philip Guy Rochford.
Right, this is the book that we're reading from, right? So go ahead.
At the age of 7, Anthony Savage left his homeland, Syria.
Everybody can know on YouTube.
At the age of 7, Anthony Savage left his homeland, Syria, crossed the Atlantic Ocean, and settled in Trinidad and Tobago. On the ship traveling to the west, he came face to face with a black man for the first time.
All right, so he, at the age of 7, he traveled over the seas, right? He came on a ship, and that was the first time he saw a black man. Right, so in Syria where he lived, apparently like he never saw a black man before in his life, right? So go ahead.
That frightened him.
Right, so that frightened him by seeing a black man. Right, go ahead.
Anthony and his family members traveled on a French vessel from Beirut. It was there he saw a black man for the first time who was a member of the crew. The black man offered him a banana, and he turned and ran away as frightened as could be, thinking he had met a visitor from another planet.
Right, so Anthony Norman Savage thought a black man was from another planet the first time he saw it. Right, this is the man who's running Trinidad right now. Right, this is, he thought he was from another planet. Right, of course, when I say black, I mean Israel. I ain't talking about them dirty Africans.
Oh,
talk about Israel, right? And of course, Israel is blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indian people, right? Remember, put the phone on silent, right? So I'm good. I'm like, what?
Anthony did not speak English, but was enrolled in Nelson Street Boys School in Trinidad. But he soldiered on and was able to become integrated within the school and community.
Right, so he didn't speak English. Right, so whatever language he spoke, but he didn't speak English. And he was at Nelson Street Boys. He went to Nelson Street Boys in Trinidad. Right, the same 1% in the Syrian community, right, who boasted the Nelson Street Boys in Trinidad. Right. Well,
at the age of 14, Anthony's father took ill and he was left with the responsibility of operating his father's small store on Queen Street.
Right, so that means that they didn't come here poor. They came here with money. His father had a store. Right? If his father had a store, he came here with money. Right? So they wasn't poor. Right, they always had. So I don't know who was the person in that room about. There was poor and they come here broken, they had nothing. There was oppressed, whatever. Right, they come here with money. Right, so, go ahead.
The transition to full-time status in his father's store was a real possibility. An episode occurred when Anthony visited Barclays Bank to take responsibility for a bank loan that his father had taken.
Right, so they're taking out loans, all kind of thing they're doing. Go ahead.
The bank manager was pleased at this young man's sense of responsibility that created a banker and customer
relationship
that proved useful hereafter. Mm-hmm. This was just the
Mascara, you on YouTube on the phone? Who on YouTube on the phone?
This
see if any comments.
Just
see if any comments or anything.
This was just on the Great Depression of the
1930s. Just on my card. Facebook, any comments? Just let me know if any comments. I said, go back up a little bit. What did you say there?
Come on, come. An episode occurred when Anthony visited Barclays Bank to take the responsibility
on YouTube
for a bank loan that his father had taken. The bank manager was pleased at this young man's sense of responsibility, and that created a banker and customer bond that proved useful hereafter. This was just on the Great Depression of the 1930s, followed by the Second World War.
This was the Great Depression of the 1930s, right? Somebody look up. What is the Great Depression? The 1930s. What is the Great Depression? Great Depression in 1930s.
Hello, Cancer.
Yeah, go ahead.
The Great Depression. The Great Depression was a severe worldwide economic depression that took place mostly during the 1930s.
So it was worldwide. It was a worldwide thing, right? Great Depression during the 1930s. Go ahead.
Beginning in the United States.
Right. Beginning in the States. Go ahead.
The timing of the Great Depression varied across nations. In most countries, it started in 1929. And lasted until the late 1930s. It was the longest, deepest, and most widespread depression of the 21st century.
All right.
In the 21st.
Go ahead.
In the 21st century, the Great Depression is commonly used as an example of how intensely the world's economy can decline.
Right. So the Great Depression was a worldwide thing. Right. That was
The Great Depression was a severe worldwide economic depression that took place mostly during the 1930s.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Beginning in the United States. The timing of the Great Depression varied across nations. In most countries, it started in 1929 and lasted until the late 1930s. It was the longest, deepest, and most widespread depression of the 20th century. In the 21st century, the Great Depression is commonly used as an example of how intensely the world's economy can decline.
Okay. Go ahead.
The Great Depression started in the United States after a major fall in stock prices that began on around September 4, 1929, and became worldwide news with the stock market crash of October 29, 1929, known as Black Tuesday.
Right. So somebody else read up what is Black Tuesday? Right, so it had a stock market crash as a Great Depression that was a worldwide thing. Right, because of the stock market. Somebody else read always Black Tuesday.
Black Tuesday.
Yeah, go ahead.
Karankan, the Wall Street crash of 1929, also known as the stock market crash of 1929, or the Great Crash, is the stock market crash that occurred in late October 1929. It started on October 24th, Black Thursday, and continued until October 29th, 1929, Black Tuesday, when share prices on the New York Stock Exchange collapsed. It was the most devastating stock market crash in the history of the United States.
All right. So, one more thing that the field mentioned is, again, during the 1932 Great Depression, right, Black people who had Black Wall Street, they wasn't suffering, they didn't have that depression. I thought it was a Great Depression worldwide. Right. So go ahead, is Michael.
Okay.
You understand? We had suffered.
The Great Depression in 1950.
Yeah. Continue. You're on the same page or you flip the page already?
Flip the page.
Alright, let somebody else read.
Yeah, come on. This was just one of the great depressions of the 1930s, followed by the Second World War that started in 1939, after the end of the war in 1945. Commercial conditions and were difficult, and Anthony decided to travel to the USA and Europe to establish new business connections. On September the 27th, 2000, a function was held in Port of Spain, Trinidad, to celebrate 64 years of an exceptional working life and the retirement of Anthony Sabga at the age of 77. The then president of Trinidad and Tobago, his gracious wife, attended the function, and 400 other in attendance were there from all highest levels of government, business, and society to pay tribute to an exceptional man who had arrived in Trinidad at age 7.
Seven, right? So he had to fly away to another country, right? Because of the Great Depression, right?
Right.
And so he didn't come here poor. He had money all the time.
Okay.
Right, so that story about he was poor and he came here broken, right? Again, you then need the story book here, so we will see as you continue to read.
Unlettered in poverty, who had grown to be the chairman of the largest and most successful conglomerate in the Caribbean.
All right, so walk up a little bit. Just have maybe a line, just a line on top.
Can. Unlettered in poverty.
Up there. A line on top.
Exceptional man who had arrived in Trinidad.
All right, so Sabga was an exceptional man who had arrived in Trinidad at age 7. Right?
Unlettered in poverty. Who had grown to be the chairman of the largest and most successful conglomerate in the Caribbean.
Right, so poverty, right? Chance, I can look how you mean have poverty here, right? I don't understand, right? They say poverty, that's it, having poor. Right? But since you're reading this book, it tells you he came here and his father had a business, so he wasn't poor. So why all of a sudden they say he poor? So I guess in the is apparently, I don't know if it's the media or if it's the Syrian community themselves trying to push an agenda to say that, hey, let me tell everybody in the world that he was poor, but really and truly he was rich.
Can't.
Can't. Can't. Can't. So you understand?
Then,
so the same book we read in Tenet, Savga came here. His father had a business. So he wasn't poor, but then after Tenet, he was poor, so I don't understand. You understand? So the Syrians and them, they're pushing an agenda to make people feel that they was poor. But it wasn't poor. They came here rich. Right? The East Indians and them didn't came here poor. You understand? They came here, they work, they get money. We came here. Never say we came here. We was forced to come here. And after we was forced to come here, they make us work for no money. You understand? So you understand? So it's we the ones who was unlettered in poverty. As that book says, Savga and them wasn't, they wasn't in poverty. The East Indians and them, they wasn't in poverty. The Chinese wasn't in poverty. Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians, these are the ones who was in poverty. So I'm continue to read.
Anthony Norman Savga was born in Syria in 1923. His main influences on his early life were from members of the Syrian community that had already settled in Trinidad when he arrived at age 7.
Right, so it already had Syrian people in Trinidad before he arrived. Right, so go ahead.
Those pioneers who bravely left Syria, their country of origin, to settle, to seek freedom, brought with them the knowledge and culture instilled in them by their forefathers.
Right, so that they say to seek freedom. And the Syrians that came to China, they came to seek freedom. I don't know what freedom they're talking about, but again, as time goes along, we might see what they're trying to say. So they're trying to seek freedom. You understand? And what were the forefathers? What did you say about the forefathers?
And culture instilled in them by their forefathers.
And culture instilled in them by the forefathers, right? Culture wasn't instilled in black people. And culture was instilled in the Native Indians and the Hispanic. But again, during the times of slavery, right? During the Renaissance, you understand? Everything was shipped from us. So we had no knowledge of our forefathers. We had no knowledge of what our forefathers instilled in us. So we just had to learn everything from the so-called white man. And we had nothing at all. But Savga and them still, they said they're seeking freedom, but things were still instilled in them by the forefathers. You understand? I mean, they're already free. You understand? So go ahead.
They were under harsh socio-political conditions on religion, on religious conflicts that were prevalent in Syria under the rule of Turkish Ottoman Empire.
All right, so some of you look up that now, the Turkish Ottoman Empire, what is that? In a country, what is that, guys? So there was under harsh rules by the Turkish Ottoman Empire, right? Harsh rules. Oh yeah, I want to see what is the harsh rules. I like to see what is the harsh rules. What was the harsh rules that Savga and them went through?
Tarokan.
Yeah. Well.
The Turkish Ottoman Empire.
Sorry. Yeah, go ahead and read. Turkish, where is that? The Turkish Ottoman Empire.
The Turkish Ottoman Empire was simply like also known as Western Europe, as the Turkish Empire, or simply Turkey, was a state that controlled much of the southern of the Southeast Europe, Western Asia, and North Africa between the 14th and early 20th centuries.
It was founded at the end of the 13th century in the northwestern Antonolia in the town of Sokop, modern-day Balik province, by the Oghuz Turkish tribal leader Osman I. After 1354, the Ottomans crossed into Europe, and with the conquest of the Balkans, the Ottoman was transformed into a transcontinental empire. The Ottomans ended the Byzantine Empire with the 1453 conquest of Constantinople by Mehmed the Conqueror.
Right, so basically, I believe this was a Muslim country, I believe, if I'm not too mistaken. What you had read before, Makai, was there was another rulership. You had reading?
Can.
Mm-hmm.
They were under harsh socio-political conditions on religious conflicts that were prevalent in Syria under the rule of Turkish Ottoman Empire.
Yeah, right. So I believe it was a Muslim country, I believe so. Right? The Muslims and them. Right? The Muslims and them are hard believe, right? So go ahead and continue to read.
Which led many Christians to leave their homeland. Anthony Norman Sabga was relatively oblivious to the stress felt by his parents living in a tiny village of Arez.
Right, so the Ottoman Turkish Empire, there was under so much stress, they made Christians leave. Right? They made some Christians leave. Right? And Anthony and them was under plenty of stress. Right? So, go ahead.
Which was 7 kilometers from the large village of Shawahed. Arez was a little village close to Shawahed in Syria in 1920. Arez was in a beautiful green valley of about 30 to 40 inhabitants.
All right, so is A-N-E-Z? I think it's Anez.
A-R-E-Z.
A-R-E-Z. All right, no sweat, but see, this place on here is right. It's a beautiful green place. All right, like say, South Ghana used to be. That would say, right?
Ghana.
No beautiful green place. We Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indian people is. I mean, it might have a green place, but to say beautiful, you understand? We in hell, Israel in hell, right? So you might go by some green place, you go see drugs here, all kind of unlawful stuff there, right? If it's Israel. So again, this is why we come here. Right? This is why Commandant General Yohannes in 1969, we come here to really bring back the nation of Israel, trying to tell them, hey, stop smoke weed, stop selling drugs, right? Put down the guns, come back to the laws, come back to the brotherhood, laws like the Bible. This is what the ISHBK has been trying to teach since 1969. We're trying to take black people out of the prison system. And that's why we was going to the prison system to talk to them, take them out of the prison system, recondition their mind. Because apparently the prison system not reconditioning their mind. Not telling them who they is and who the cult is. And you could imagine if you go into prison and they tell every Israelite, when I say Israelite, I'm talking about black people. Tell them, hey, Christ was a black man. God is a black man. The angels was black. You go into prison. Imagine you telling these inmates and them that in prison. Eventually they go put on the gun. They go realize, wait, now the prophets and them was black boy. Christ was a black man, boy, the man who really coming back to control you. The Most High, the Lord. who have all this power, who created this earth, to a big bang, an explosion. And he's a black man. Eventually they're gonna pull on the gun. They say, nah, I want to give me motivation. Because all the time the church making them think that black people was spits, dogs, coons. You understand? The church was making them think that all the time. So this is why we sent from 1969 going out on the streets and teaching us black Hispanics and Native Indians. We are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. And the only way for us to rule the planet Earth is to keep the laws. You understand? Stop following the white man, stop following the East Indians and worshipping Mother Lakshmi. Mother Lakshmi has no power. Stop worshipping Buddha. Buddha ain't had no power. Stop worshipping that, what do you call that stone in Mecca? What it says a meteor? The Kaaba stone. What fall from the sky that says a meteor? And fall from the sky, stop worshipping that. And all I'm thinking is idol tree. Right? The Lord never meant for no black person to be no Muslim. The Muslim is of another race. That religion belongs to a race, the Arabs and them. Because the Arabs and them who built slave ships, right, for black people to go into slavery. Right? The East Indians and them. Women have no power, and we have no right to be no, what do you call them? East Indians and them?
Hindus.
We have no right being no Hindus. You understand? The Lord going to punish us and pour us more in hell. And we definitely have no right being no Christian.
Okay.
Because Christianity is the number one cause for black on black. If you walk in church, you are agreeing to the homosexuality. If you walk in church,
okay.
You understand? Pastor molesting all them children and them and everybody saying, well, okay, God loves you even though he is a sinner. You understand? So the church is the number one cause of black on black crime. Church does just lie and tell it things like, you know, why can't church just lie? So much things.
So
the seed. Church just lie and say, yeah.
Tell it to sow a seed and buy hand culture.
So I see them by hand culture.
Like
yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Like
yes,
sir. Prayer, cloth, and holy water. Like yes, sir. Rosary.
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead, tell us. Okay. See, just to break the Mosaic commandment that the Mosaic laws no longer is a way, but they wanted to collect tithes and pray for prophet.
Mm-hmm.
Pray for prophecy and this kind of forgiveness.
Right, yeah. And imagine as a murderer and I come in church. You understand? Again, this is why we had a tank commander, Jeremiah Hansen, since 1969, you know?
Okay.
Teaching us the truth about the Bible. If I was a murderer and I come in church, I go back up being a murderer. Because why? I come in church to change my life. And the pastor saying, nothing if it's a sin, God still love you no matter what you do. Or the law's done away with. I don't murder and I come here to change my life and the pastor telling me that. I can remain being a murderer. You understand? So, this is why we come to do what it is we have to do here. In 1969. Right? You don't see any, you don't hear any rumors of wars through the air. Russia and China, America. All them things, the scriptures, you understand? I mean, if you come Moses and Christ, you know, if World War III come, still Moses and Christ, because, you know, if World War III come, that means we're going to save more sisters and brothers before it happened, right, before that World War III happened. But I just tell them, you know, I just pray for World War III to come every day. The first nuclear bomb, it should drop right here in China. You understand? This place they've fallen America too much. She's not watching America and watching all the evil ways and following it too much. And so if that first nuclear bomb, she just dropped right here in China. When whoever started the war, if it's America or Russia or China, whoever, a jet should just fly to bomb up Russia and accidentally a bomb chopper from his car fall in China. You understand? Again, the scripture says, you know, the child will protect me. Yeah. So whoever in the truth, right? Again, the truth is in the ISUPK. Whoever in that truth, that child is going to protect you. Right after World War III, we, the men in the ISUPK, going to control the planet. So you oppress now, Sabana oppress us now, the East Indians, the Chinese, they're oppressing me now, but you just have a whole strong, obey the laws, do eat pork, crab, shrimp, and lobster, stop selling drugs, right? Stop killing people, stop being homosexuals, just keep the laws, and you know, eventually you'll get a blessing. And so, where are you there, Maka?
The nearest villages were about 5 to 6 kilometers away. Muslims and their descendants owned the land and around Arez. The Muslim family was El Zubai, and they allowed farming on the land at a price. It was 75% of the produce, and the system was called crop sharing. There were no village council or any representative body, so the villages had to accept the arbitrary decision of the landowner.
Right, so the Muslims and them owned the land, and they wanted 75%, right, of the money that is on the land. Right, of course, then we were talking about the Christians. Muslims and them was oppressing the Christians, of course, that's what we were talking about, right? So go ahead and continue to read.
Can. Products were plentiful and varied, like wheat, barley, maize, and lentil peas. In summertime, cucumbers, watermelon, and tomatoes were grown. Arez was about 6 to 7 kilometers from Shawahid. Many families in the area were related to each other. A family might own a mule or donkey and use it to transport goods.
All right, so that they're talking about the Christians, right? Christians, right? They own mule or donkey. They own mule or donkey, but the Muslims sell them that pay 75% on the land, right? They still had 25%. 25% they still had. Right, they still have. So again, we had nothing. You understand? So Sabgana wasn't poor. It was never poor. They came here rich. They had money. Even if it was just one donkey alone they came here with. We came here with nothing. You understand? All we came here with was our pride and dignity. And even that alone was taken away from us. Right?
So
like
you
said. Yeah.
We came free on a ship, we came in chains.
Yeah. We came in chains, we came forced, they came willingly on a ship. You understand? Nobody never died on the ship. You understand? So, go ahead.
The peasants in the area owned cattle, camels, and oxen. Shawahid was almost on the boundary between Muslim sector and Christian sector. All the families of Arez were Christian.
All right, so all the family of Arez was Christian.
By the end of the WWE.
By the end of
World War II.
Right, World War II, right? By the end of World War II, go ahead.
Sibian declared it independent from the French mandate. Joseph Braza Tabga, the man who left behind a life of treachery and inspired his family.
Yeah, no question on Facebook.
So we have another rule of the Ottoman Church. These people could have left their Christian behind, belief behind, and embraced the Muslim faith in exchange for special treatment in the Arab society. The Syrian was under Turkish control and was part of the Ottoman Empire until 1914. And the Ottoman, an outbreak of the World War I, there were major religious groups in Syria, the Christians and the Muslims. The Sabra were Christians and the Amada Procterian tenants of the land. Christians were not allowed to own that land as the family had worked for several generations. All these farmers paid heavy tithes to the land was eventually prohibited, and a few Christians had two freehold ownership of the land. The Muslims were treacherous in many.
I'm sure. Are they in Shan? Are they in Shan, right?
In many respects,
The Muslims were treacherous in many respects and were antagonistic to Christians.
Right. The Muslims were treacherous in many respects and antagonistic. Right. Yeah, antagonistic. Go ahead.
The two-tier poll tax was enforced that Christians paid twice as much tax as Muslims.
Right, so there was antagonistic. You look up the meaning of antagonistic. Right. Anybody know what the meaning of that? Antagonistic? Richard?
Okay, so if you ever can remember what really means or the context of it is to be somebody to provoke somebody. Provoking.
So, somebody look it up.
I don't care. Antagonistic.
Yes.
A person who actively opposes or is hostile to someone or something, an adversary.
All right, somebody who's hostile to an adversary, right?
I don't care.
Right, so remember that. So I'm continue from antagonistic.
Antagonistic to Christians.
So the Muslims was antagonistic to the Christians, right? Good. And Sabganam the Syrian community was Christian. So go ahead.
A two-tier poll tax was enforced that Christians paid twice as much tax as Muslims.
And so they're saying the Christians had to pay twice as much tax as the Muslims. Right? Go ahead.
Five branches of the Sabra family migrated to the New World: Brazil, South America, USA, and Mexico.
And so the Sabra family was migrated to the New World, which was
Brazil, South America, USA,
Mexico. Right. Go ahead.
Anthony's branch of the family remained in Anez.
Right.
Many fathers did not send their girls to school in fear of them coming in contact with Muslim boys.
I didn't send the girls to the school because I didn't want the girls get in contact with the Muslim boys. All right, so continue, girl.
Being led away from their religious teaching, so the girls stayed at home.
All right, so that they let the girls stay at home. All right, of course, they will let them learn, they will learn at home. They won't send them to school, right? They won't want them to mix up with the Muslim boys and them. And so where I'm so happy that.
Sure it was just Muslim boys.
that's what the book say. the Muslim boys and them. And so I can remember the Muslims was oppressing the Christian. The word they used, they had them poor, and letter in poverty, as the word they used, because they made them pay twice as much tax. Right?
Look at that definition of unlettered, as you said, poverty. The word unlettered means a person poorly educated or illiterate.
A person poorly uneducated.
Poorly
educated
or illiterate.
All right.
Like, yes, I find it's kind of hypocritical because say he was 8'7", but before that he obviously went to school. Even based on what they're saying, he didn't stay home, but the boys went to school.
Yeah, and that was what he just read. I was in Trinidad when there was
when in Syria.
Right. So he went to school when he was in Syria. When he came in Trinidad, he was in Syria. But I said he was what? Unlettered, he was what?
Unlettered
meaning?
He was poorly educated or illiterate.
Poorly educated meaning he didn't really have much education.
Right? But he had some.
But he had education. Right? I can't read.
I'm not sure if I'm tracing the story right or if I'm able to break it down better for me. But what they were trying to escape was this fear when they went back into Syria when they fled it and the time of the Great Depression. So on the first day they were trying to flee from these kind of conditions we're talking about. Where they was highly taxed them. They had to pay more tax to the Muslims and then as they found
that what it was in Syria.
In Syria. So when they leave, when they come back here, they flee at 8-7 or somewhere around there. The 1930s, around somewhere there where the Great Depression started coming,
right?
So when they reach across there, that's what they're trying to flee from.
Yeah, that's what they're trying to flee from. The Muslims oppressing them. That was basically Chinese. That was, you know, a little backdrop with the Arabs and them, you know, them the Arabs and them used to own private whorehouses.
Oh God.
Right? Right, the people that the Arabs and them owned, or the people that the Arabs and them oppressed, they had four houses.
Okay.
Right, of them, right? That's a backdrop. Yeah, go ahead, Kazo.
So I guess I'm not too sure if this rumor is true, but they say that the Muslims, as well as the whole houses, not to show too much for the house, they are not for the whole history of the whole houses, but there's known for the poppy plant, selling opium. And a big level, so there was big drug dealers at that time as well. Coming up with that, I think that big in the history of selling, they have a big field in Afghanistan where they have the same opioid plant. It's the same thing, and they manufacture the drugs in a big way, opium.
All of that is, yeah. I should have tried to remember I can't recall it right now, but it had a president. Right. Our president, I could get his history about that. Right, what happened was at that time he had fund, I believe it was Iraq for one of them.
Okay.
Money.
Right.
Right, because everybody knew that the Iraq was known for, as they say, opium and the drugs and stuff, right? So what I was saying was that time, again, I'll get the history about it. So I want to talk too much, but then I'll get the history, correct? President name, everybody, right? I'm going to correct him. I want to talk too much about it, and I can't remember, right? But yeah, go ahead, Mark.
Nilam Anthony's parents had formal schooling, and his three sisters were never sent to school. Though they were very bright, knowledge was passed from generation to generation by informal gatherings, discussions, and storytelling that took place every evening. Religious composition in Syria at that time was 20% Christian and 80% Muslim Christian.
Right, so start of our real so from where's
neither of Anthony's parents.
Neither of Anthony's parents, right?
Had formal schooling.
Had formal schooling.
And his three sisters were never sent to school.
Right, and his three sisters was never sent to school. Right? Because we all know, as he just read, because of the Muslims, they didn't want them to go to school because of the Muslims, right?
Okay.
Right.
Though they were very bright, knowledge was passed from generation to generation by informal gathering, discussion, and storytelling that took place every evening.
Right, so they get their information through storytelling. You used to gather every evening itself? Every evening they gather, and everybody would talk about the history and whatnot. And that's how they'll get information, right? Storytelling. And they might tell about what happened in Syria, you know, with the forefathers. Right? Say all kind of things. Right? So what them would gather in the evening, and how they storytelling. You understand? So go ahead.
Religious composition in Syria at that time was 20% Christian and 80% Muslim.
Right, so 20% Christians, 80% Muslims. Right? So the Muslims are never over any Christian.
Okay.
That's why I was able to say, all right, I'll go pay double now.
Okay.
On the tax on the land. I'll pay 75%.
Okay.
Understand?
Okay, sir. Who's the Sunni? There's two different factions. I know, well, the Christian family and the Muslim family in Syria, but I can't remember the name of the next one. And I can't remember who is who. That is Sunni and some other one. You have it in the article as well, or
probably it's in the article. They turn as you go on.
Okay.
You didn't know exactly what?
Yeah, which one of them is the Sunni and who it is? Now, no one of them is Christian. One represents Christian, one represents the Muslims. I can't remember which one is the Sunni, and I can't remember the name of the next faction. And split the solar series split into two, but then two different factions.
Good enough, man.
Christians were forced to convert to Islam in order to maintain a acceptable livelihood.
Christians was what?
Christians was forced to convert to Islam.
Christians was forced. Right, to convert to Islam, right? Again, that thing, what Islam is just an unruly type of religion, right? Force them to convert, right?
And violent.
And violent, right? And then people saying we trying to breed people into ISIS. No, that's not true. We don't force people into this religion. We don't do that. Well, again, Slack, yeah, this is not a religion. Right? First to begin, this is not a religion.
Right.
What we doing right now, we're building back our nation.
That
the Lord gave laws to this nation. Just like how Trinidad had laws, our Father gave us laws to this nation. Right? So we're trying to build it back up. It's not a religion. Religion is a man-made thing.
Good.
Right, and we don't do no ISIS thing, we don't do no none of them Christian garbage.
Good.
We are accepting homosexuality.
It's like, yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's a damn undisciplined people, sir. We want people, sir.
Right?
Yeah.
Right, so again, we're not ISIS.
Good.
We have no affiliation with ISIS. Right? We do not work with ISIS. We do not call nobody from ISIS. You understand? Right? So, again,
let's also look at this as how Islam is violent. Christianity also is extremely violent.
Yes, that is correct. That's how Islam is violent. Christianity is violent too, as well. Right? Yeah. But on this topic here, I want to bash Islam a little, because people come at us with ISIS and ISIS. Not no ISIS. Okay. ISIS don't teach people how to stop crime.
Okay.
ISIS don't teach people how to stop smoke weed.
Okay.
Or stop sell drugs. We just teach people, hey, you gotta stop sell drugs. You gotta stop smoke weed.
Okay.
Stop being homosexual. Stop being a whore. And love your brothers and sisters. That's what we just teach. ISIS don't teach those things. We have no dealings with ISIS. We are not affiliated with ISIS. If anything, we are against Islam and ISIS. We are against them.
That's true.
Right? We are the ISUPK out of One West Harlem Street, New York. Right? Under Commander General Yahana, since 1969. We have been teaching that Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians are the lost 12 tribes of Israel. Right? And how we're going to rule this earth is by keeping the laws. Right? How we're going to keep the laws, you know, the laws have brotherhood scriptures. Right? Give my brotherhood scripture. Right?
First John 4:20.
Right? The one. Yeah, verse. Right? That's the one. One that I like. You give me anyone. Give me any brotherhood scripture, right? That ISIS don't teach.
Right?
Give me a brotherhood scripture. How? Yeah. Give me anyone. Any.
Like I said, they twist this one. Mm-hmm. They don't apply it, sir. Like John 15:12-14, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, like the man who laid down his life for his brother, sir. They want to pick up a bomb and they do it for selfish reasons. That being, it would never happen.
Yeah, now we.
But Allah, but.
Nah, we don't do that. The scripture says, envy thou not the oppressor, and choose or follow none of his ways, right? So, we don't do those things, right? Any brotherhood scripture, anyone? Give anyone in 18? Anyone, right? There's a ton of brotherhood scriptures, right? Ton of them, there's plenty. Mm-hmm. Like, give me one in 18. Right, with the Publican and them, right? But you read from on top. You say one thing one on one, right? Yeah, go ahead. Well, I read it. Well, in Jeremiah 18?
Book of Matthew chapter 18 and verse 21.
It's lucky.
Yeah, but you talk about I'm going to one on one, yeah.
Karakam. The book of Matthew chapter 18 and verse 15. Moreover, if thy brother shall trespass against thee.
Right, so if that brother has trespassed against thee, right, do you something wrong, do you some harm, you know? Then go ahead.
Go tell him his fault between thee and him alone.
Right, go and tell him his fault between him and him alone. Right, they didn't say go and tell the whole congregation, go and tell a friend on the road. Right, because that's the first thing people like to do, right? Somebody do me a harm. I like to run down the road and tell my neighbor, tell the barber man, what this person do, man, you know? If he's sleeping with my wife, or if you find he washing my wife too hard, if he match my shoes, if he thief my money, I go run and tell him, you know? The scripture say, no, don't do that. Go and tell him it's fall between him and who?
And thee alone.
And thee alone. Right? Go ahead.
If he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother.
And if he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother. And the scriptures didn't say go and bust open the head or go and tell him join ISIS or whatever like that. Right? Say go and talk to him one-on-one. That's a brotherhood scripture, them things just teach. Right? So crime will be less amongst the black community. Right? This is what we just teach. We just teach love, brotherhood. Right? You don't teach about sharpen up a bomb on the chest and go and bomb some country. No, don't teach those things. No, we are against that. Right? Continue, Master. You can?
I don't can. But if he will not hear thee, then take with thee one or two more, that in a mouth of two or three witnesses, every word may be established.
Right? So if he hear you, if he's still saying about thing, you know, he hear you. Bring one or two more people and I'll talk to him and reason with him. You understand? They what we just teach. Right? No violence and bomb and nothing like that, right? So if there's anything we are against Islam and we are against ISIS, right?
Yeah.
So Master, which part is you? Which part do you reach? Two who you?
Go to school in Trinidad. Going to school in Trinidad was difficult for Tony. With 30 to 40 students in class, Tony not being able to communicate one word of English created hardship for him. The family spoke Arabic at home. His father could not carry on a convo in English.
Right, anyone. So the family spoke Arabic at home, but they could not speak English. Right? Go ahead.
With anyone.
They couldn't speak English with anyone. Right, go ahead.
As the children grew older, they moved out of the rooms and took over the second story of a building at number 6, Marine Square, which was named Independence Square.
Mm-hmm. So, city and building again.
Number
as
6.
They grew older, they took over a building of number 6, what?
Marine Square.
Marine Square.
Which was named Independence Square.
Which was named Independence Square. Right? So, where?
The subjects he seemed to excel in was mental arithmetic. When the teacher asked the class to do
calculations, or is it?
When the teacher asked the class to do calculation in their head, they could not
do it.
Answer.
Mm-hmm.
And everyone turned to Tony for the answer.
Right. So he was good in maths. He alone know maths, basically. That's about what the channel say. Yeah, go ahead.
And he would always give the correct answer, and this left an indelible imprint on his mind. He used that. His name Anthony, and the word answer to the business acronym, ANSA.
Right, so he alone was good in maths, right? Anthony, he alone was good in maths. Everybody used to go to him for the answer, right? So he came up with a business idea. Hey, my name is Anthony, and everybody come and me for the answer. So his business acronym was
ANSA,
which stands for answer, Makar.
Okay.
Right? Ansa Makal, right? That was the conglomerate. Group of companies. Ansa Makal. Right? That's how we got the business idea, by bringing those two together.
At Nelson Street, RSC School for Boys, Tony was not registered as Sabra, but Anthony Norman. Nelson Street Boys School was one of the most outstanding government schools in the country.
Right, so read over again.
At Nelson Street RSC School for Boys, Tony was not registered at Sabga.
Right, he was not registered at Sabga. At Nelson Street Boys, right? Go ahead.
But Anthony Norman,
that was registered as in school. Go ahead.
Nelson Street School was one of the most outstanding government schools in the country. All of the pupils.
Just a side note, remember, everybody going to for him for the answer, right? So we can't really say anything that he was smart, right? We can't really take it serious, right? Because why? Yeah, go ahead.
Because they're writing the stories, so they're writing the narrative, and they say he was poor, he was money, he was very rich.
Right. And even though he's smart, Muhammad was what?
Black, yes,
sir. Yeah.
And illiterate also, sir.
Muhammad was illiterate, and Arabs worship him, even though he's illiterate.
That was good.
Yeah, so really, so them heathens and them go worship you, whether you're illiterate or you're smart. Whether you're smart or illiterate, they worship you. Right?
That
so it don't really matter. Right? So yeah, go ahead and swap.
All of the pupils were of Indian and African descent. There were as well Chinese, Spanish, Portuguese, Syrians, and others.
Right, so those are the people who was in the school. Syrians, Chinese, one of them was in the Nelson Street School, right? Right.
Tony's father became very ill in 1938.
Right. His father became ill now in 1938. Right.
And was diagnosed with tuberculosis.
Right? I don't know if tuberculosis is right, like some infection with your lungs. Right? I think you get that through. Apart from somebody coughing, if somebody coughing and have an AC vent, the coughing could get that tuberculosis. If somebody close to you and the coughing could get that. Also, you could get tuberculosis through dairy products. Right? That was something in the past that was. They look at two dairy products like milk and thing. You used to get tuberculosis from animals now. Animals get two dairy products, drink it, wherever you used to get tuberculosis, infection in the lungs. Right, so yeah, go ahead.
That was considered to be incurable. It was, however, reported through the Syrian Lebanese community that recoveredness from the disease were known to have occurred in the mountains of Libya, of Lebanon.
The disease had to be what? The disease?
However, reported through the Syrian Lebanese community that recoveries from the disease were known to have occurred in the mountains of Lebanon.
Right, so let's say, all right, in the mountains of Lebanon, your father had tuberculosis. If you go to the mountain of Lebanon, it would have rumors that the tuberculosis was cured in that mountain of Lebanon. You understand? So go ahead, Swap.
His father took a loan from Barclays Bank from $1,500, which was granted by his cousin. This enabled.
Of course, in that time, $1,500 was plenty money, right? $1,500, $1,500 was plenty money in that 1930s time, right? Well,
this enabled Naeem, who was Anthony's father,
what? Let's what they can read now for the time. And so, his father went to the Barclays Bank, right? So he had a loan and the loan was approved for $1,500, right? So just remember that that was his cousin, right? Yeah, that was his cousin went to the bank. And then she was on them own them banks and them, right? That was his cousin. All right, them like to make it feel like if them smart and we dumb, when it's the other way around. We's the smart one and them is the dumb one. You understand? We know what's going on. Them feel we don't know what's going on, but we know what's going on. You understand? Then training in the media. You understand? Or we go to do crime. Nah, we go to do crime, man. Don't worry, that go and change us, man. The kingdom of heaven is going to come. You understand? New world order is going to come.
Good.
And you will order of only righteous men and women.
Good.
And the one whose needs to be put in chains, they're going to be put in chains and pick our cotton first. Who is the heathens? Right? Who is the heathens? The Chinese, the East Indians, the white man, the Arabs. You understand? Who are they? The Africans. You understand? The Amalek, who's so is the Jewish man.
Okay.
Understand what I'm going to put in chains.
Okay.
Understand? As you to keep our order.
Okay.
Right? And our king is going to be our shy. Christ. Okay. He's going to be our king ruling. He deserves to be our king, man.
Okay.
And he come here and go sin. And then he teach us how to keep the law. Now he deserves that from.
Okay.
Understand? He deserves that from. You understand? So yeah, go ahead.
Okay. This enabled Naeem, who is Anthony's father, to travel to Lebanon and hope of finding a miracle cure for tuberculosis. Tony had only just joined the special class at Nelson Street RC School, boys, but was encouraged by George to leave school and join him in the store. It was hard for them. George 17 and Tony 13. Naeem decided for his own reasons to register the little haberdashery store as NS Slakia, as NS Sabda.
Alright. So that was brothers, right?
NS Sabda and Sons.
Alright. So he wanted to rename the store NS Sabda and Sons. Right. Go ahead.
Even though they were infants.
And two of them was how old?
17 and 13.
17 and 13 years. 17 and 13 years.
Okay.
All right. 17 and 13 years. So you can imagine we had nothing. Right. So when they say he was unlettered in poverty. Right? When they say he was unlettered in poverty. So he was the one who was unlettered in poverty, right?
Okay.
Go ahead and read on.
It is the custom in the Arab world for a son to ease Slovakia, for a son to carry the father's name as a second name. The grandfather was named Solomon Totoni. Totoni's father was called Naimi Solomon or Norman Solomon.
So it was a custom, once again, it was a custom.
It is the custom in the Arab world for a son to carry the father's name.
It's a custom in the Arab world for a son to carry father's name.
As a second name.
As his second name.
The grandfather was named Solomon.
Grandfather was named Solomon.
So Tony's father was named Naimi Solomon or Norman Solomon.
So Tony's father was named Naimi or Namin, Naimi Solomon, right? Because his last name was what, really? Namin.
So
his last name was what? Because I think she said it had to be the second name. The last name had to be the second name. So they took the last one, paid as the second. Right, so go ahead.
The grandfather was named Solomon. So Tony's father was named Naimi Solomon.
The grandfather's name Solomon, so Tony's father was named Naimi Solomon.
For Norman Solomon.
Norman Solomon, go ahead.
That is how Tony got his name as Anthony Naimi or Anthony Norman. His eldest son is Norman by choice under Anthony Norman Sabga to carry on the tradition. It's a way of tracing a person's origin. Tony was at a disadvantage. He could hardly read or write anything. He was only good at mental arithmetic. But he was fortunate at that. Naimi proceeded to Lebanon and went
to a famous sanatorium.
Sanatorium?
Yeah.
It's not like a sanatorium.
Yeah.
Okay. Lebanon and went to a famous sanatorium. The journey from Trinidad to Lebanon took 6 weeks by boat via France. On arrival, he was diagnosed as free of all diseases.
All right, so when they went, that because that's the trip they went to Lebanon, right, to cure his father. He was sick. Right, so the journey from Trinidad to Lebanon took 6 weeks, right? Right. When he reached there, they said he have no tuberculosis. Okay, go and read it.
Apparently, the relaxation of the sea journey between Trinidad and Lebanon cured him, and the original diagnosis in Trinidad was not accurate.
Right. So what I mean, I'm to tell you. The diagnosis in Trinidad wasn't accurate.
Yeah.
So that is. But this thing in a long time. This is why you see all them government ministers and them big business people flying out of the country to get better. Yeah. Since back then the medical institution in China was poor. Since back then, like, it was poor.
If I'm mistaken, at that kind of time, when I was saying white people, them same people who only buying degrees online and then kind of thing, setting them up the same place. So what expect again?
Read on, because they said it was his relaxation on the sea made the cure,
right,
or made him get back better from the tuberculosis.
So
but obviously you don't get cure from tuberculosis like that. So it had to be a misdiagnosed that the Trinidad doctors gave him, right? So go ahead.
And S. Sabga and Sons used to open at 7 a.m. and close at 7 p.m.
From 7 to 7, right? They're working, right? Right.
When the store closes, Naomi will often visit family, particularly Abdul Sabga. All the family members were the living blocker. All the family members were then living a few blocks away from each other. It was the beginning of a Syrian Lebanese community.
Right. Yeah. So all the families and them was living close to each other, just a few blocks away.
Good.
That was the beginning of the Syrian Lebanese community.
Good.
Right? Because of course when they come here, you know, they come with their ox, some mule, some cattle. Mm-hmm. They used to pay 75% at the tax that the Muslim told them to pay in Syria. So they had 25% money that they came down here with. So they came with money and some animal, whatever.
Right.
And that's how they started up. So there was never poor, there was always rich.
Okay.
Came here, they oppressed black people again, they oppressed Israel.
Okay.
You understand? So, I mean, all this is a proof that the Lord, you know. What we come back to is ours.
Okay.
So he's doing us something. What the Lord doing us right now? You see, Sabga and all them have money, they come here with money. It's Indians and them come here. What the Lord doing us right now? We're doing us something.
Okay.
What are you doing us?
Yeah.
Like,
not only
correcting
us, provoking us to jealousy.
Provoking us to jealousy. Give me a piece of her.
Like, yes, sir. A business, sir, but make a nation, not a nation, something, sir, along the way. Provoking the jealousy.
Very peace, sir.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Maka, correct, right?
Okay.
Yeah. Provoking us to jealousy.
Okay.
And this is why you see Sablan coming here with money. Mm-hmm. And they have power, they could say, well, yeah, he's the most powerful in Trinidad. Like these Indians that come here, these people are big to pitch the road, Junior Sammy.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? The Lord provoking us to jealousy.
Okay.
Right? So,
would the Syrian and Lebanese community, would they be major players in the time when the cotton textile industry would have been at its peak when the East Indians came across here and benefited of us working, picking the cotton fields to bring the same money for them to get the same money that Junior Simon and have? But would the Syrian and Lebanese community be the major players in terms of having the control of the ship ports and all that vessels and to bring across that money? That is why some of the biggest amount of money they would have reaped from that same cotton textile industry, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Syrian land control everything. Mm-hmm. Or you could boast and say it.
Okay.
There's a few of them, but it's the most powerful.
Okay.
And you have 150 restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
Let us call them the Starbucks.
Yeah.
And Trinidad, of course, he owned many things. And well, apart from that, Sabga, the whole Sabga community are talking, you know, they own what? Mario's, Pizza Hut, Rituals.
Mm-hmm.
They have some steaks in the KFC. Mm-hmm. Right? And Wagon. Right?
Like I said, in the oil and gas field, other companies.
So all other companies that they own in the oil and gas field. Right? Wagon, so they own. Yeah, go ahead. Tell us.
Massey Group of Companies.
Massey Group of Companies.
Mm-hmm. And some of the
Standards. Standards they own.
Okay. So like I said, I think Ricardo was now saying courts, also Lucky Dollar, which is the same thing. Yeah.
I'm too sure about courts. Mm-hmm. Courts.
Sure.
I'm too sure about courts.
Standards.
Standards, yeah, no standards for sure. Standards, mm-hmm. They own.
So like I said.
Yeah.
So like I said, they own American stores as well?
Yeah, no standards. Okay. No for sure. Yeah. Standards, though. They also own the Carib. Carib company. Right? Grand Bazaar. Grand Bazaar they own.
Right.
You understand? So what people want to say something? Yeah, provoke jealousy, yes.
Romans 10 and 19.
That's not what?
Those are Nila Massey.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, the car industry.
Yeah,
which is what I believe is Honda. Honda, Mitsubishi. You understand? They own all that. Right? And more. And more, they own some hotels. As you say, you have 150 restaurants in Trinidad, and more they own. You understand? So go ahead, what we have?
Romans 10 and 19,
yeah. It had a better one I wanted, but go ahead, let me read that. Go ahead and read that one.
But I say, did not Israel know? First Moses said, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you.
And that Romans, well, that song is similar to the one that I'm going to say, so I'm going to just the one in New Testament. Romans what?
10 and 19.
And, yeah, go ahead and say it. Go ahead and read it.
But I say, did not Israel know? First Moses said, I will provoke you to jealousy by them that are no people, and by a foolish nation I will anger you.
Right, so a foolish nation, you will anger us, right? You provoke us to jealousy. A foolish nation, you will anger us. You're watching these foolish Chinese and them, right? These foolish Arabs and them who worshiping a rock, the Chinese worshiping who? Buddha? You understand? These Asians, these East Indians and them had a god. You understand? So, people provoking us to jealousy by this foolish nation. People worshiping a rock, statue, and stone. You understand? But it's our next one I wanted, the Old Testament.
I don't know if I know something. Is the scripture in Romans, I mean, Ecclesiastes 10 and 7 talking about the same thing? About the same situation that we're in right now?
Never hear. Ecclesiastes 10 and 7.
Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses and princes walking as servants upon the earth.
And princes walking as servants
upon the earth.
Upon the earth. I'm too sure about that. I would ask the captain about that. Right? So but the one
you're looking for is in Deuteronomy 32.
32, yes. 16. 32 and 16. Mm-hmm. It's in 32. It's in 32, but 21, right? Deuteronomy 32 and 21. Deuteronomy 32 and 21.
Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 21. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God, which is not the Mosaic. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities. And I will move them to jealousy with those which are not a people. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation.
Right. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God. What I say? They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not. Yeah, well, Tazo.
We provoke the Mosai by worshipping things that is not a power. There are no power, there are no strength. No. Yeah, so we provoke the Mosai. So he's saying now, in verse, he will provoke me now. But nation, like, you see, we have that.
It's
the waste of time before. Yeah,
just that talking about idol worship.
Right here, idol worship. In my example, remember, with the scripture say he provoked the jealousy with that which is not God.
So,
yeah, idol worship, yes. But yeah, give me four names, you know.
Worshiping
Caesar Borgia, right? Yeah. Go again.
What was saying something?
Yeah, Maka, you say something?
Yeah, Canon. I was going to say the same thing at them. Professor Sowak said them.
She's a Borgia. She's a Borgia. Who again?
Yes,
not either.
Islam.
Islam. With the cover stone, right? Or the rock. Right? Whether that is walk around seven times and bow and kiss and worship it. I don't know again, let's do it. I don't know, let's make love with it. I don't know, right?
Yeah, so like you said, all people having sex with other nations, drugs, money, worshiping money,
right? Money, yeah, our God, right? Yes, what were these Indians and them? What did they say? Yes,
Hinduism,
right?
Kali statues,
right? Mother Lakshmi, right?
Yeah.
Kali, so like right.
Believing in the foolish prayers.
Mm-hmm. Those things is not good. Those things have no power.
Yeah.
Right? Again, of course, you know, when I say God, I'm already talking about power, right? Talking about power, right? So those things have no power. There's only one power on the face of it, and it's the Most High.
Right?
Don't know that precept. Right? I don't know your scripture. We. The prophet went to the man and he dipped him in the water and he get healed.
Right.
And from that he said, all right, from this day I know there's only one God on the face of the earth, and that is the God of Israel.
Okay.
That prophet, sir,
awesome.
The man, he had lotus.
Okay.
So the prophet went and dipped him in water.
Okay.
He didn't believe, but he dipped him in the water. And he come out and say, yeah, boy, there's only one power on the face of this earth. And I say, I'm power of Israel. Let me see if I can find that.
Is it Nehum? Yeah,
what's it say? No, I believe it. But just now, before I just keep on doing 31, 32, and 21. Let me see if I could find that. So I could find that scripture. I think it's in Samuel. I believe it's in Samuel. It's in Samuel. Let me see. You see, from that day he knew that there is no other God but the God of Israel. So I could find it, eh?
Like I said, there's a paraphrasing. There's the one where people would step over the same man and would go when he come and stir the water, then whoever get in the pot of food. But the man was leprous. Whoever thing, but there's a different story I referring to.
He was leprous, but I believe it was in Samuel. It's in Samuel or 2 Kings, boy. I think it's in 2 Kings, just somewhere. Right, it's in 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 15. 2 Kings.
I don't count.
That's somewhere. Let's see where you figured. 2 Kings chapter 5. Let's see if we can start that. Alright, so read from verse 30.
Hello, God.
Yeah.
Book of 2 Kings chapter 5 and verse 30.
Mm-hmm.
And his servant came near and spake unto him and said, my father, if the prophet had bid thee to do some great thing, wouldest thou not have done it? How much rather then, when he said to thee, wash and be clean? Then went he down and dipped himself seven times in the Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And his flesh came.
Read from verse 10.
The book of 2 Kings, chapter 5, and verse 10. And Elijah sent a messenger unto him, saying, go.
Elijah, I think that is Elisha. I believe it's Elisha.
We said, and Elisha sent a messenger unto him, saying, go and wash in the Jordan seven times, and thy flesh come again to thee. Be clean. Shall be clean. Verse 11. But Naaman was wroth and went away and said, behold, I thought he will surely come out to me and stand and call on the name of the Lord his God and strike his hand over the place
and recover the leper.
Well.
Are not Abana and Pharpar rivers of Damascus better than all the waters of Israel? May I not wash in them and be clean? So he turned and went away in a rage.
Right, so you're trying to say the other water is better than this, the water in Israel, you tell me to dip in? He said, nah, the other water is better than that, them water. So you walk away in rage, man.
Right.
Go ahead. Verse 13, right?
Verse 13. And his servant came near and spake unto him and said, my father, if the prophet had bid thee to do some great thing, wouldst thou not have done it? How much rather than when he said to thee, wash and be clean? Then he went down and dipped himself seven times in the Jordan, according to the saying of the man of God. And his flesh came again, like unto the flesh of a little child, and he was clean.
Right, so when he went and he dipped himself now in the water, he was clean from this leprosy.
Okay.
Right, so where now, verse 15.
Verse 15. And he returned to the man of God, and he and all his company, and came and stood before him. And he said, behold, now I know that there is no God.
And now we know there is no God, there is no power. Go ahead.
In all the earth.
In all the earth. Right.
But in Israel.
But in Israel. Finish it off.
Now therefore I pray thee, take a blessing of thy servant.
Right. So this man, he even props. He said, now what? My leprosy get cured by just dipping myself, this prophet. And I use Elisha, tell him to dip myself seven times, right?
Okay.
Now what? This... There's no power on the face of the earth. He didn't say face of the world, right? He said face of the earth.
Okay.
There's no power on the face of this landmass.
Right.
Except the God of Israel, except the Most High. He's the only power on the face of the earth. And you realize that?
Okay.
You understand?
So like, yes, sir.
Yeah.
And I don't get back to the remembrance of the story. I can't remember the full thing.
Yeah.
But I remember the man picking up a fuss for the dirtiest river. Then the man, like, you find the dirtiest river in all Israel. To tell them to go and dip yourself in Jordan. And I like it all because people just like to say, if it ain't look like this or whatever, if it ain't like that, I don't want it. They're not from the Most High. And they find we just look so rugged. We can't be at the Most High. But the Most High taking the ashes of the earth there and making diamonds out there. Get on care.
Yeah. Okay, so you can imagine that once you really come back to this Bible, but you can get to understand that boy, we is holy men.
Okay.
Different from one of other people. Our Lord is a holy God.
Okay.
And once you keep his laws and commandments, as Christ says, we will do better than him. We will do better than Christ.
Okay.
And so once you keep the laws, Christ said we could do better than Christ. You understand? So, you see, keep the laws, right? The amount of, I didn't want to say magical, but the amount of
spiritual power.
Right? Spiritual power, I didn't want to make it sound too. thing, right? Well, the amount of godliness that people do. If we come back to the laws of the Bible, we could heal the sick, cure the blind. You understand? Yeah. Well, let me go back to Deuteronomy 32 and 31. Let me finish off that. See, watching the time, right? Yeah, right. So, start from the idea, they have provoked me.
Okay. Deuteronomy chapter 32 and verse 21. They have moved me to jealousy with that which is not God. They have provoked me to anger with their vanities, and I will move them to jealousy with those which are not a people.
Right, you will move them to jealousy with those which are not a people. Right, go ahead.
Okay. I will provoke them to anger with a foolish nation.
Right. You provoke them to anger with a foolish nation. Right, so, of course, you know, let's talk about Mother Lakshmi and them people, you know, they're over us. You know, during Assam, Yovawi, the prison of Moralashmi and Krishna, the Chinese and them over we, the prison Buddha, the Chinese open up all kind of Chinese restaurant all over Trinidad. You understand? Who again? Sabga and them, Christians, them Arabs and them, worshipping a rock, Christians worshipping some wood, right? Like worshipping Sija Borgia, and they over us. We worshipping the true power, which is the Most High. And yet still, them other foolish nations over us. Because why? We sinning against the Lord, that is all. So you don't say to come back to the lost. You don't say to rule the earth. So keep the Lord's statutes and commandments of the Bible. All right? All right, so I'm trying to get to you. So with that, let's pass the class off to priest and officer Sawa. Priest and officer Sawa Yala.
We at the ISUPK out of One West, 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commander General Hanna. New rules for brothers and sisters. When a new brother or sister comes into the school, they are off limits for 6 months. They are to be saluted only. They are here to shed themselves of the world. After 6 months, if a brother or sister is interested in a particular person, he or she must be permitted, must get permission from the head to speak to a brother or sister. There's another 6 months in which the brother or sister will court each other. After this 6 month period, the brother or sister will get permission from the head to marry. Ties, which is a commandment. You will find this in Numbers chapter 18, verse 21, and Malachi chapter 3, verse 8 to 10. Means tenth in Hebrew and is pronounced Mayasharam. 10% of every penny of increase the Lord gives you, you give to the treasury department or teacher. Priest fund, free will offering for priests, not mandatory. Whatsoever amount you would like to give. Upcoming holy convocations. Remind Akiam and Akwatiam to check on social media such as ISUPK.com, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and so on for ISUPK events and materials. If a brother wants to be a trooper in the school, then he should start wearing all black, which includes black boots, like shirt, like pants, like headbands or scarf. With that, I'm Madiam. Rise and face these.
Yeah.
They say the Lord's Prayer in Hebrew. Abanawa.
Abanawa.
Shabashamayam.
Shabashamayam.
Wadash.
Wadash.
Aya.
Aya.
Shamaka.
Shamaka.
Yahawa.
Yahawa.
Malakwata.
Malakwata.
Taba'a.
Taba'a.
Ratazaka.
Ratazaka.
Aya.
Aya.
Aisha.
Aisha.
Barataza.
Barataza.
Bawa.
Bawa.
Aya.
Aya.
Bashamayam.
Bashamayam.
Natanalawa.
Natanalawa.
Nakam.
Nakam.
Kal.
Yawam.
Yawam. Wasalaknawa.
Wasalaknawa.
Wabatnawa.
Wabatnawa.
Wasalaknawa.
Wasalaknawa.
Wabatyanawa.
Wabatyanawa.
Wala'a.
Wala'a.
Tabayanawa.
Tabayanawa.
Wanasayawan.
Wanasayawan.
Abal.
Abal.
Awashayanawa.
Awashayanawa.
Ayan.
Ayan.
Rai.
Rai.
Kaya,
Kaya,
Laka,
Laka,
Amalakwat,
Amalakwat,
Waala,
Waala,
Wataparat,
Wataparat,
Ayolamyam,
Ayolamyam,
Aman,
Aman,
in English.
Right, in English, what he said was, Our Father,
Our Father,
in
which art in heaven,
which art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name,
hallowed be thy name,
thy kingdom come,
thy kingdom come,
thy will be done,
thy will be done,
in earth,
in earth,
as it is in heaven,
as it is in heaven.
Give us this day,
give us this day,
our daily bread,
our daily bread,
and forgive us our debts,
and forgive us our debts,
as we forgive our debtors,
as we forgive our debtors,
and lead us not into temptation,
lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil,
but deliver us from evil,
for thine is the kingdom,
thine is the kingdom,
the power and the glory,
the power and the glory,
forever,
forever,
so be it,
so be it.
Don't say the Akka. Yahweh,
Yahweh,
Baasham,
Yahushai,
Babakashai, Natananawa,
Akka,
Akka, Lapara, Kalmakayala, Wa Wakal Madawa,
Wakal Madawa,
Akka,
Akka,
Bataa, Ha Matazarayam,
Ha Matazarayam,
Akka,
Akka,
La
La
Laquam,
Laquam,
Ha Ha Aquatiam,
Ha Aquatiam,
Ha Akka,
Ha Akka,
Aila Rakawat,
Aila Rakawat,
Ha Makatayal,
Ha Makatayal,
Lalasharan,
Lalasharan,
Baasham,
Baasham,
Yahushai,
Yahushai,
Wada,
Wada,
Aman,
Aman.
In English, what he said was Yahweh,
Yahweh,
in the name of Yahushai,
in the name of Yahushai.
Please give us the power.
Please give us the power.
The power to heal.
The power to heal.
All manner of sickness.
All manner of sickness.
All manner of disease.
All manner of disease.
The power to cleanse the lepers.
The power to cleanse the lepers.
The power to raise the dead.
The power to raise the dead.
The power against unclean spirits.
The power against unclean spirits.
To cast them out.
To cast them out.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So be it.
So be it.
This is the blessing and the power structure. Barakata Yahweh.
Barakata Yahweh.
Wa Yahushai.
Wa Yahushai.
Wa Makayala.
Wa Makayala.
Wa Alpayam.
Wa Alpayam.
Matazabaya.
Matazabaya.
Al Wapa Yahana.
Al Wapa Yahana.
Al Wapa Yahana.
Al Wapa Yam.
Al Wapa Yam. Al Wapa Yam. Al Wapa Yam.
Asharayam,
Asharayam,
Aquatazayam,
Aquatazayam,
Yam Yam,
Aka Ya Yalyam,
Aka Yalyam,
Yam,
Wa Aquatiam,
Wa Aquatiam,
Yahweh,
Yahweh,
Baasham,
Baasham,
Yahushai,
Yahushai,
the Wada Aman,
the Wada Aman.
In English, what he said was, bless you, Yahweh,
bless you, Yahweh,
and Yahushai,
and Yahushai.
And Michael.
And Michael.
And the angels.
And the angels.
Commanding General Yahana.
Commanding General Yahana.
The general.
The general.
The captain.
The captain.
The officers.
The officers.
The troopers.
The troopers.
And the sisters.
And the sisters.
Yahweh.
Yahweh.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
Name of Yahweh Shai.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So be it.
So be it.
Right. Blessed are you, Yahweh.
Blessed are you, Yahweh.
King of heaven and earth.
King of heaven and earth.
And all things living.
And all things living.
Yahweh.
Yahweh.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
Listen to us now.
Listen to us now.
Right now.
Right now.
Send evils and curses.
Send evils and curses.
And punishment and destruction.
And punishment and destruction.
And death to the heathen.
And death to the heathen.
That speak against us.
That speak against us.
Thy prophets.
Thy prophets.
The teachers.
The teachers.
The princes.
The princes.
The priests.
The priests.
The Israelite brothers.
The Israelite brothers.
And the school.
And the school.
Send evils and curses.
Send evils and curses.
And punishment and destruction.
And punishment and destruction.
And death to the heathen.
And death to the heathen.
And shake loose the pockets.
And shake loose the pockets
of the rich of Israel.
Of the rich of Israel
that refuse to give to the school.
That refuse to give to the school.
Force their riches.
Force their riches
to enter into thy sanctuary.
Enter into thy sanctuary.
Send evils and curses.
Send evils and curses.
And punishment and destruction.
And punishment and destruction.
And death to the Edomites.
And death to the Edomites.
and the nations,
and the nations,
and the drug dealers,
and the drug dealers,
the court system,
the court system,
the prison system,
the prison system,
Planned Parenthood,
Planned Parenthood,
all the governments of our enemies,
all the governments of our enemies,
Amalek synagogues and armies,
Amalek synagogues and armies,
Roman Catholic Church,
Roman Catholic Church,
the Pope,
the Pope,
Islam,
Islam,
Christianity,
Christianity,
Egyptology,
Egyptology,
Militia,
Militia,
Ku Klux Klan,
Ku Klux Klan,
Aryan Nation,
Aryan Nation,
Skinheads,
Skinheads,
Kwazi Kumutazi,
Kwazi Kumutazi,
the Gay Movement,
the Gay Movement,
Lesbian Movement,
Lesbian Movement,
Spies,
Spies,
Workers of Witchcraft,
Workers of Witchcraft,
NASA Space Program,
NASA Space Program,
Army,
the Army,
Navy,
Navy,
Air Force,
Air Force,
Marine,
Marines,
Wall Street,
Wall Street,
open up the internet,
open up the internet,
and the airwaves,
and the airwaves,
the cable access channels,
the cable access channels,
and the radio channels,
and the radio channels,
convict the spirit,
convict the spirits
of any of thy people,
of any of thy people
that seek to stop us,
that seek to stop us,
and bring swift death to all,
and bring swift death to all,
the heathen,
the heathen
that stand in our way,
that stand in our way,
or try to stop us,
or try to stop us
from broadcasting our words,
from broadcasting our words
to all the planet Earth,
to all the planet Earth.
Let loose all terrorists,
let loose all terrorists.
Force them to go to and fro,
force them to go to and fro
through the Earth and destroy,
through the Earth and destroy.
Force the terrorists to come against America,
force the terrorists to come against America.
And Trinidad,
and Trinidad,
and destroy them,
and destroy them
in their strongholds,
in their strongholds.
Let America shake.
Let America shake.
Let Trinidad shake.
Let Trinidad shake.
At the hands of the terrorists.
At the hands of the terrorists.
Let Yahweh shine.
Let Yahweh shine.
Michael.
Michael.
And Gabriel.
And Gabriel.
Come down with the flying saucers.
Come down with the flying saucers.
And kill all the heathen.
And kill all the heathen.
That come up against us.
That come up against us.
As we speak thy word.
As we speak thy word.
Cause it to be known by all.
Cause it to be known by all.
That it is the angels.
That it is the angels.
That have done it.
That have done it.
Cause it to be spread throughout the media.
Cause it to be spread throughout the media.
Throughout the whole world.
Throughout the whole world.
Cause them to shake at thy coming.
Cause them to shake at thy coming.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
In the name of Yahweh Shai.
Thank you always.
Thank you always.
So be it.
So be it.
Bless Israel.
Yahweh,
Yahweh,
Bahasham,
Bahasham,
Yahweh Shai,
Yahweh Shai,
Barak Lanawa,
Barak Lanawa,
Bayashala,
Bayashala,
Wabiyat,
Wabiyat,
Sepharim,
Sepharim,
Barak,
Barak,
Rapha,
Rapha,
Magan,
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 Magan.
The officers,
the officers,
right? Captains,
captains,
right? Troopers,
troopers,
right? All the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the truth.
All the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the truth.
Right? Tashika,
Tashika, right?
Healer,
Healer,
Tessiah,
Tessiah,
right? Kobe,
Kobe.
Tazapa,
Tazapa,
Mapataza,
Mapataza,
Yapa,
Yapa,
Tamar,
Tamar,
Aitisha,
Aitisha,
all the brothers and sisters in the ISUPK,
all the brothers and sisters in the ISUPK,
all the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK,
all the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK,
generals,
generals,
captains,
captains,
the officers,
officers,
troopers,
troopers,
Commander General Diana,
Commander General Diana,
generals,
generals,
Captain,
captains,
the officers,
the officers,
troopers,
troopers,
Kayalwana,
Kayalwana,
Barak Lapash,
Barak Lapash,
all the brothers and sisters in the ISUPK,
all the brothers and sisters in the ISUPK,
Yakav,
Yakav,
Mataza,
Mataza,
Radaf,
Radaf,
all Israel,
all Israel,
Commander General Yan,
Commander General Yan,
generals,
generals,
captains,
captains,
officers,
officers,
troopers,
troopers,
sisters,
sisters,
children,
children,
brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK,
brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK,
Jaden,
Jaden,
Dana,
Dana,
have mercy upon all the destroyed of Israel,
have mercy upon all the destroyed of Israel.
All the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK,
all the brothers and sisters fighting to come into the ISUPK.
Officers,
officers,
generals,
generals, Troopers,
some of Biala,
Apataza,
Yapa,
Aisha,
Tamar,
and all Israel.
Commandant General Yana,
Commandant General Yana,
all the captains,
all the captains,
all the officers,
all the officers,
troopers,
all the troopers,
all fighting the coming to ISUPK,
all fighting the coming to ISUPK,
Shamka,
Shamka,
Kaya,
Kaya,
Yapa,
Para,
Para.
Commandant General Yana,
Commandant General Yana,
all generals,
all generals,
all the captains,
all the captains,
all the troopers,
all the troopers,
all the officers,
all the officers,
all the young men,
all the young men.
And all fighting the company to the ICPK.
And all fighting the company to the ICPK.
Janice,
Janice,
and
Zion,
Zion,
Wesleyan, Daniela,
Daniela,
all Israel,
all Israel. All
right.
Is it? Good.
Basham,
Yawashai,
Yawashai,
Tawadaman,
Tawadaman.
Right, what we said in English was, Lord, in the name of Yahweh Shai, bless us and Israel and the school. Bless, heal, shield, protect our loved ones. In the name of Yahweh Shai, thank you. So be it.
Let's give the teacher one Scottish salute.
Men
of Israel, I'm Adyam Shabbat. I'm Adyam. Barak.
Yahweh Shema Shabbatah.
Yahweh Shema Shabbatah.
Adimata. Still not busy, sisters. I'm Adyam Shabbat. I'm Adyam. Barak.
Yahweh Shema Yalatabah Shema Shabbatah.
Adimata. God is dismissed.